Hello ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mr. Tardis and welcome to another Doctor Who Viewing Figures Breakdown video. Now before we get to Kablam and the Witchfinders, there's something I feel the need to bring up, and that is the BARB 28-day viewing figures. Now this is a quite recent addition to the BARB. Normally they just report overnight and the 7 days, but recently they are now doing 28-day viewing figures, where they will monitor on-demand programming for an additional 21 days after the 7-day viewing figures. To my knowledge, between Doctor Who Series 1 and Doctor Who Series 10, we don't have any figures like that, so these are going to be unique to Series 11. So I'm going to make sure that I'm completely fair when comparing Doctor Who 7-day viewing figures to other Doctor Who 7-day viewing figures. I'm not going to compare, let's say, The Woman Who Fell to Earth's 28-day viewing figures to other stories which only have 7 days. What I will do is I will just present the numbers, but I will not do comparisons, because I think the numbers are interesting and are worth pointing out, especially since they are now the final BARB figures that are not going to go up anymore. But I'm not going to do something like compare Kablam's 28-day viewing figures to Planet of the Ood's 7-day figures. It's just not an equal playing field. I know some people might take umbrage with me even just mentioning these numbers, but you have to be fair, you have to keep up with the times. For example, in 2005, the figures would count BBC Three repeats. Remember that? Before BBC iPlayer, if you missed a Christopher Eccleston episode of Doctor Who, you would have to catch it on BBC Three the next day. And then when BBC HD became a thing for the first time, the BBC and the BBC HD numbers were considered separate. It's just the evolution of how these numbers are tracked, and I think it would be disingenuous to ignore these numbers. So let's compare the 7-day to the 28-day viewing figures for the first three episodes of Series 11. For The Woman Who Fell to Earth, we went from 10.95 million to 11.45 million. For The Ghost Monument, 9 million to 9.8 million. And for Rosa, 8.41 million to 9 million. In terms of standard, normal, regular episodes, not Christmas specials, not anniversary specials or anything like that, this is the first time since Doctor Who came back in 2005 that we have had three episodes in a row top 9 million. Since Doctor Who came back, we have had 11 standard normal episodes top 9 million viewers, and 3 of those were in Series 4, and 3 of those were in Series 11. But once again, full disclosure, between Series 1 and Series 10, these are 7-day figures, not 28-day figures. But for Series 11, these are the final figures, these are the ones that will be cemented in history, so these are the ones I have to work with. What I'll do in early to mid-January 2019 is take a look at all of the 28-day figures for Series 11 and see how it stacks up. I did a poll on Twitter asking people how they wanted me to tackle this subject matter, and people seem to unanimously agree, talk about all of the numbers. But anyway, let's not talk about the past, let's talk about the present with Kablam, which now has official 7-day viewing figures of 7.46 million, up from its original overnight ratings of 5.93 million. These figures make Kablam the 9th most watched program of the week. It fell behind I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, both when editions of Strictly Come Dancing, Dynasties, 3 episodes of Coronation Street, and The Apprentice. And we'll get to the positives in a moment, but I have to admit that last week I did jump the gun slightly, but I was kind of well within my reason to, because I thought that Kablam would top 7.5 million, beating Planet of the Ood's 7-day viewing figures. To be fair, I wasn't far off. Kablam only fell behind very, very slightly, which is still an accomplishment, because Planet of the Ood was the 3rd episode of the series, and Kablam was the 7th of this one. But still, for Kablam, I thought we were going to get a figure that was just under 7.6 million, and the reason I thought that was because I crunched the numbers. I took a look at all of the 7-day viewing figures of all of the Series 11 stories so far, looked at the overnight, compared it to the 7 days, and marked the percentage difference. All of that is on the screen right now. The Woman Who Fell to Earth had a 33% increase, The Ghost Monument 26, etc, etc. And using this trajectory, getting rid of The Woman Who Fell to Earth, which is an obvious outlier because it was the first episode of the series, I thought Kablam might have a 28% increase from its 5.93 million overnight figures. 28% of 5.93 is 1.66, add that to the 5.93, and you have 7.59 million. I aimed for the previous trajectory suggested by the previous 6 weeks and fell short. But can you blame me? Kablam just seems to be a weird outlier. But if you look at the sci-fi space set stories like The Ghost Monument, The Saranga Conundrum, and Kablam, their 7-day viewing figures amount for around a quarter of the total figures. Whereas historical stories like Rosa and Demons of the Punjab, that's nearly approaching a third. So it seems that the pattern for Series 11 is that if you want good overnight figures, you go for a sci-fi story, but if you want longevity on the BBC iPlayer and on-demand catch-up, you go for historical. Why is this? Hell if I know, I'm just presenting the figures. But what I do know is that Kablam being the 9th most watched programme of the week is the 7th time in a row that Doctor Who Series 11 has consistently been in the top 10 viewership for the week. And that is something that in the revived series Doctor Who has never been able to do. Buckle up folks, we're going to talk about a lot of numbers in this episode, it's a reason why this episode is a day or two late. For Series 1, we had one episode break the top 10, Rose. For Series 2, we had 5 episodes and 2 of them were in a row, Army of Ghosts and Doomsday. For Series 3, we had 3 episodes, none of them in a row. For Series 4, we had 9 episodes, 5 of them in a row, going from Forest of the Dead to Journey's End. That is one hell of a consistent viewership and so far is the high benchmark in terms of audience rankings. For Series 5, we had 6 episodes break the top 10 and 2 of them were in a row. Well, technically twice, it was the first two and the last two. For Series 6, we had one episode break the top 10, and that was The Impossible Astronaut. The rest of them are more skirting around the bottom teens, the high 20s. For Series 7, it was 5 episodes, 3 of them in a row, the first 3. For Series 8, 4 episodes, 4 of them in a row. For Series 9, none of the stories cracked the top 10. And for Series 10, one episode cracked the top 10, and that was the pilot, and even then it just skirted in there. So for Series 11, we have 7 episodes. All of them cracked the top 10. And in terms of the sheer volume of stories that are going to crack the top 10 in terms of audience viewership, Series 4 has 13 episodes and Series 11 has 10. But once again, Series 4 was basically the peak of Doctor Who. So the fact that Series 11 is only just slightly lagging behind it, but is proving to be more consistently watched. But the numbers just further cement that Series 11 has the highest viewing figures for the past 10 years of Doctor Who. And not only that, but people are consistently watching in high volumes. You either want consistency or you want high figures. Series 11 has the best of both worlds in this case. And yes, in terms of the 7-day viewingship, Kablam is the lowest of Series 11 so far, but it's still literally the highest viewing figures since Peter Capaldi started as the Doctor. You have to go back as far as Deep Breath to find a 7-day viewingship as high as Kablam. And also, every single series since 2005 has gone below 7 million viewers for at least one episode, except for Series 11 so far. Once again, consistency, high figures, Doctor Who Series 11 is doing incredibly well. But Trilby, why are you talking about this top 10 ranking now? Why don't you wait until the end of Series 11? Well, that's because I know that The Witchfinders is not going to be in the top 10, but more on that in a minute. We have to talk about the theming that we gave Kablam last week. Conspiracies in space! So yeah, like I said before, Kablam only just slightly missed out on the benchmark that I gave it last week, which was Planet of the Ood. But as predicted, it did pass The Doctor's Daughter, it did pass Silence of the Library, although that of course was without question. It bested Smile, it bested Time Heist, and it only just by a smidge bested The Rings of Akaten. But one final note about Kablam before I finally move to The Witchfinders. A lot of people took umbrage with my title of the video last week saying that the viewing figures are going up. I don't see why that was controversial. Demons of the Punjab was watched in the overnight viewership by 5.77 million, Kablam was watched by 5.93 million. That was an increase. I mean, I didn't say it was a massive increase, but objectively 5.77 is a lower number than 5.93. Like, I don't get why this is up for debate. Why are we literally just lying about numbers now? Did I jump the gun in terms of the 7-day figures? Yes, and like I mentioned earlier with the percentages and the 7-day figures and everything, I gave my reason why I did that. But in terms of the overnights, which is what I title the videos and theme them towards, yeah, I was still correct. But finally, let's talk about The Witchfinders, which had overnight figures of 5.66 million, had an audience share of 27.9%, and was the 4th highest rated programme on that Sunday night, and the 19th most watched for the week. For the Sunday night, it fell behind I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, The Strictly Come Dancing Results Show, and Dynasties. And I know what many of you are thinking, blimey, last week the overnight figures for Kablam made it the 10th most watched, but now The Witchfinders has gone to the 19th, why is that? Well, 7 of the top 10 slots for this week for overnight viewership were taken up by episodes of I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here. It's on basically daily, so it's going to massively skew the charts. It's why I said earlier that The Witchfinders will not make the top 10 for next week. Unless it gets 7-day viewing figures of over 8 million, but I don't think that's going to happen. 28 days? Maybe. I don't know. It's way too early to tell, but 7 days, it's not happening. And when these overnight figures dropped, I got a lot of YouTube comments, I got a lot of Twitter notifications saying, ha, it's the lowest overnight viewing figures of Series 11 so far, I can't wait to see how Trilby tries to spin this into a positive. Well, I'm gonna spin it the same way I always do. By telling the truth. Yeah, it is the lowest overnight figures of Series 11 so far, but when you look at that audience share of 27.9%, as long as Doctor Who is in the high 20s for that figure, it means that a lot of people are still watching. Once again, it's all about consistency. And speaking of consistency, when I was trying to find equivalent stories to the Witchfinders, the same phrase kept on coming up time and time again when it came to the overnight figures. And that term is the lowest of the series. Vampires of Venice at the time had the lowest overnight figures of Series 5, The Crimson Horror had the lowest overnight figures of Series 7, Eaters of Light had the lowest overnight figures of Series 10. These stories, like I mentioned with Demons of the Punjab, don't do that well initially. Sometimes, like Demons of the Punjab, they can still do well, but in terms of the sci-fi stories or the regeneration episodes or some of the more Earth-theme-centric contemporary stories, yeah, they fall behind. Anyone who is surprised by this and anyone who is trying to use these relatively low figures to try and prove a point, either are just being negative for the sake of it or don't know how the numbers work. And like I've been saying for the past 8 weeks in a row, when you take the Witchfinders overnight figures and compare it to anything with the late Matt Smith or Peter Capaldi era, it bests it. It bests the Crimson Horror, Robot of Sherwood, Face the Raven, Eaters of Light, and it naturally falls behind an episode like The Unquiet Dead or Tooth and Claw and The Shakespeare Code, which was early on in those series tenures, and those stories were also broadcast during a time when 7-day figures did not differ that much from the overnight figures. And while The Witchfinders is the lowest overnight figures for Series 11 so far, it's not the lowest by a wide margin, it only just falls behind Demons of the Punjab, which, as we've just learned over the past week, bested Kablam's 7-day figures, so just because the overnight figures are low doesn't mean it is going to be the lowest when all the figures come through. But there is of course the elephant in the room, the fact that the Witchfinders did leak early on Amazon Prime. The episode was mistakenly uploaded instead of Kablam on the streaming platform, so many people got to watch it early. I don't have specific numbers, I don't know exactly how many people watched the Witchfinders early, I just thought it was worth mentioning in the context of the full discussion. But using our percentages from earlier and comparing sci-fi stories to historical stories in Doctor Who Series 11, I'm going to try and predict the 7-day viewing figures for the Witchfinders. So Demons of the Punjab was at 29%, Rose was at 31%, I'm going to go slap bang in the middle for 30. 30% of 5.66 is 1.69. Add those two together and you get 7-day figures of 7.35, which would continue the trend of dropping viewing figures week from week, however, it still places it over 7 million viewers. 8 Doctor Who episodes in a row getting over 7 million viewers. Not even Series 4 did that. Even if we go to the lower percentage of 7-day viewing figures, 25%, we still wind up with 7.07, which in my opinion is still a really good result. And I'm done. So that was all of the numbers. That was a lot of numbers, and the reason I thrust all of those on you, unfortunately, was because I know that Kablam is going to be the last episode of Series 11 to make the top 10. Because I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here is just going to dominate the charts for the next few weeks, because it's on basically daily. Unless the ending of the next episode, which is the penultimate episode of Series 11, ends with some weird game-changing cliffhanger or reveal that psychs people up to watch the last episode live and bumps it up the charts one more time. So thank you for joining me on this journey for today, and I shall see you folks next time.